So I'm Noel.
I'm Ray. Hello, sorry.
Hello.
Nag-glass.
Yeah, so yeah, so we've been together since 2010. Yeah. So, years na ba? Bilangin ko pa.
2010. Oh, we.
Ano ba? Sinagot mo na 2010.
We were we met noong 2010 and then we got married 2012. So technically technically it's been 10 years since.
Hello. Turning 10.
And then 8 years married. Nearing in
November. 9 years married this November.
Yeah, oh, 9 pala. sorry for the math.
Nahina kami sa math. For on my part, I was already doing earnings since I was high school. I'm not gonna tell you the year because I will reveal my age. But after high school and college, I stopped earnings for a while, and then I met sina Master Nathan. Hi, Master Nathan. sa Makati. So in the near the Legazpi Active Park. So he had a group there. It wasn't really anything formal. More like a gathering of
people who want to train.
People who want to train and who got together after a long while. Also, who were all
basically
UP,
for fitness.
For fitness, and they're all UP based. So because one of our teachers, me and one of my friends, our teachers knew him. And we had the same Arnie style, so we got along with them, and then then when she saw that I was doing that, I actually told her, you know, you should come join us, you know, even just for fitness and exercise and self defense. So,
pero at first, kasi actually funnily enough, I was observing them at first, kasi I'm honestly I wanted to learn Arnie's, but. I was also really there just to support him. Ayun, so at first I was just observing them, and then until I told him, I saw na parang, oy, I like what I see. I like that even women can do our knees, kasi, and I like I want to learn with you. So, ayun, that's how eventually I got on board, and Noel would learn alongside, and I learned alongside. And then kasi magkaiba kaming level of learning, of course, since mas matagal na siya. Ako naman, I had to also go through instructors and teachers. Like si JB actually taught me extensively. So from there, ayun, tulungan na. Though funny kasi minsan nag-aaway kami pag siya yung nagtuturo.
She will readily admit more that she's tired to me than to other teachers.
Yes. Kasi parang siyempre pag kayo ba teacher, parang wala akong choice. So pag siya, parang ano ba? Gaganon ako, ganon. Tapos siya, hindi, kailangan mo gawin. So strict siya as a teacher. He will be, you have to do this. Tapos ako parang, no, I don't.
So that's the dynamics of it.
Yun yung difference.
But when she's in the mood naman to really learn, she will really do it until she gets the hang of it. I guess I like it as a whole, in the sense that the first aspect is that it's practical. I think it's probably the only martial art that will always ever tell you to go pick up a weapon if you're in a fight. Because it's a fight, and you know, real fights are not honorable, they're not fair. So I think that's one of the things I got from my teacher, that you know, if it's a fight, it's either gonna end up you dead or the opponent dead, usually in the Philippines at least, in that context. So that's one thing. And then another thing, of course, is
I like that also kasi as a female, hindi, you know, that kung yun nga, from the perspective of a guy, it's already unfair or you expect na ganun. But for me, syempre, I would already assume that I'm at a more disadvantageous position. But not for anything, but simply because you just assume that somebody is better than you. So having a weapon or picking up something to defend with is definitely a better opinion for me.
What I liked is how this particular art taught us how to use our bodies. So before I had that wrong perception that one of the reasons I stopped before was I had the wrong perception that all you're ever gonna use is your arm. And then when I got introduced to Sina Nathan in 2015 or something, they're like, no, you're not supposed to do that because you're supposed to use your whole body. You know, so my training went from just the arm to be using the whole body. So
yes.
I can honestly say that I have better strikes now, I move better now, all that part. So you know, it's really a full body exercise once you get past the part where all this is you're just using sticks or you don't have a stick in real life. You know, once you get past that, really, it's really, you know, it's just gonna blow your mind, in my opinion, of course.
It's a nice feeling, you know. I mean, to be able to sweat it out and to be able to feel fit in a practical sense, diba?
Actually, one of the people I've talked to before said that she was turned off with Arnie's because of all the politics, because of the MMA. But I would say that, you know, just take all of that out. Just look at the core. It's a practical self-defense system. To me, it doesn't really matter whether it's purely Filipino, whether there were hidden aspects in dances, although they're not. But you know, the point is, it's something that would work. It's something that would teach you to use weapons. It's so you know, actually, if you're a nerdy fanboy like me, who liked swords back when he was a kid, you know, it'd be like, wow, I can actually use swords in real life, or sometimes sticks. You know, so maybe we can go about it that way, I guess. But yeah, it's definitely something very, very practical and. Really, if you don't do that, you also miss out, you know, a very good part of self-defense, one of the very aspects of self-defense, which is, you know, learning how to use weapons, you know.
It's beneficial for you because you will be aware of many things. Something simple as situational awareness, which is, for me, a lot of women should be aware of, you know, two, the fact that you can exercise at home, I mean, even in quarantine, the fact that you can use FMA as something that helps you use your body in a way that will make you proud of yourself. It will empower you to actually move past that fear. I mean, I was made to by sila nila na, thank you, but nagulat ako, okay, hold this balisong. Oh, okay, I mean, hold this talibong. Oh, laki. This is a big weapon, but hey, learn to wield it to your advantage and be confident in it. So that's something that instead of you being scared of something, you learn it, know it, and be friends with it. And then that's something for me is very beneficial. Instead of being afraid of something you don't know, then being aware of it is a plus.
If you were to encourage someone to try FMA, so wala silang alam, wala silang experience, what would you say to them, or how would you go about encouraging them? If at all, baka ayaw
niya. Wag na, joke.
We definitely like to encourage.
Joke.